Hello everybody, Dev here, and I'm back playing Skyrim. It's still snowing. It was snowing last time, I believe, and honestly, this snow does look a lot better than in the original version, I'll give it that. So, don't get me wrong, I don't, you know, dislike what they did with this game, it's just I wish they had done more. I think it was just slithering all around. I feel like they could have just done a little more with it, but I'm not going to get on ranting about the how it's the special edition and it's supposed to be this graphically superior thing and my mods did a better job at it. I'm going to be focusing on my quest. Side quest, really. I'm going to be searching for the gaulder amulets once more. Just had to pick up those snowberries. The snowberries are fantastic. Okay. So, God, I gotta wonder how solo Let's Players that do solo commentaries are make it a little less redundant. Let's players that do solo commentaries, I gotta wonder how they come up with all of their content, like, for the stuff that they talk about, because quite frankly, in the last episode, I was just about all out of ideas for something to for stuff to talk about. Not even halfway through. I was just sort of rambling on, I feel like, at the very end there. Don't really know what else to do about didn't really know what else to do about it. It's kind of hard to do. I didn't think it'd be that hard to just talk about kind of pretty much nothing for 30 minutes. Oh well. So, yeah. Oh, there's that book again. So, come over here, read Lost Legends, and now I have to go and, yeah, so I did have the quest of the, Forbidden Legends, Under Sarthal. I do have that quest, and I should go and talk to the Archmage, but, he can wait. It's not like that thing's going anywhere until he takes a look at it, so. Ooh. Huh, I think that's new. This archway actually has a physical boundary for the snow. That's really cool. Isn't that cool? I don't care about your opinion. Oh, something I'd actually noticed about the special edition, I couldn't find Sky UI on the Nexus, but Sophia, the mod that puts in the most perverted woman in Skyrim, is on there. What the heck? Seriously, Sophia, this follower that you meet the first time you meet her, she's practically naked, sleeping in a place where they keep the horses. I don't really recall what that's called at the moment, but sleeping in a place with where they keep the horses on at Whiterun, drunk, pretty sure hungover actually, and will constantly make sexual innuendo jokes. And talks about other stuff, I guess, but most of the time it's just I think that guy was just fighting a wolf, because I saw a wolf that oh, this is ridiculous. No. I will take your robes. I like your boots. Taking your boots. What am I wearing? Currently, the novice stuff. Okay, so I'll put the boots on. How's this? Magic regenerates 50% faster. I like the sound of that. I mean, this is nice, but... Oh, magic regenerates 50% faster, and it gives a bonus to my destruction. I'm gonna keep this, then. Yay! I'll just keep the bow, or the arrows, just in case I feel like using it. But, yeah, I think that guy was fighting a wolf, because I saw a wolf that had some sort of icy magic thing happen to it. Well, if there's one good use for wolves attacking you, it's that you can get their pelt to turn into leather. That's nice. But yeah, Sophia is on the Nexus for Special Edition, but SkyUI, the thing that makes the item menu so much better, just exceptional, is not. The thing that was probably my favorite mod is not on there. Cool. I'm sure it'll be on there eventually, but I'm surprised it wasn't on there before this random follower. I mean, I could understand if Indigo was on there. Huh? Oh, hunters. I could understand if Indigo, if Inigo was on there, because he's an awesome follower. She was a decent follower, but she got annoying really fast. Because though she had custom voices and quite a bit of dialogue, it repeated a lot. And she always did the same thing every time you walked up to High Hrothgar, talking about a front wedgie. It was just like perverse childish humor, and it annoyed me. I don't know if any of you liked it, but I liked it at first, and then it got boring. What does this do? Expert locks. Yeah, that's useful. I mean, maybe when you're low level in lock picking, but when you get high enough level in lock picking, it doesn't really matter now, does it? Okay. There seem to be a lot more wolves in Skyrim than there used to. Or is that just me? Could just be that I typically fast travel everywhere I go, and I don't really have the luxury to do that right now, so that could be it, but at the same time, what the heck? Blood? I don't remember this. Something was injured and ran in here. Hobbs Fall Cave. I've been in here before. I don't remember the blood leading up to it. That's a lot of empty bottles of wine. I'm betting this is vampires. Okay, where is that coming from? Ah, possibly necromancers. Not possibly, definitely necromancers if they do anything towards... Yeah, necromancer. It's only a novice. Human flesh. Lovely. Ooh, 75? That's a dark elf. Okay, there's one thing I gotta give Skyrim credit for, and that's its ambiance. This place, oh man, these dungeons and such always creep me out. Good lord. Just with the ambiance, like, you never know when something's actually behind you, if it's just the way they have the sound set up. Now, where was that voice coming from? Oh, I'm betting it was coming from up there. I will have to find a way up, but I'm betting I have to go down to go up. Hmm. Is that a dark elf? That's gotta be a dark elf. I hear a skeleton.
Hi.
They're just a bunch of novices. I don't even know what they're doing. I'll actually keep that because 75% magic resistance is really nice. Or magic regeneration. Regeneration, not resistance. Resistance would be awesome. Wait, what the heck? Hi. Oh god, no. Jump back, jump back, jump back, jump back. Don't fall. I guess I'll take your arrows just in case. His carp, soul gem. Conjuration. That'll be handy. Once again, you're just in the office. Is everyone here just a novice? Oh, you're an apprentice. That's something, at least. Are you seriously running away, you coward? Well, I can't actually blame him. I would probably run away if somebody was shooting balls of fire at me as well. Because that hurts. Ooh, lesser ward. I already have that, but I will take that to sell it. I can actually probably sell the robes as well for a good price. Ow. That hurt. Hello once again. Oh, still a novice? You're a high elf, aren't you? Unusual gem. That thing is such a pain in the butt to find every part of. Any books in here that are worth reading? Nope, don't look like it. The Exodus. Take that. Oh yeah. Still actually haven't done the alchemy thing off camera, but I will eventually do that so you guys don't have to suffer through the guess and check. Because the guess and check is boring and nobody wants to see that. I thought that was marshmallows. Looked like marshmallows. I wouldn't complain. Marshmallows are delicious. Wait, he brought back a goat to fight me? I mean, I get the guy's a novice, but seriously? My lockpicking isn't that high, so shut up. Come on, I can... I'm right there. Thank you. Never had such difficulty with such a low-level lock. Adrian Daedra, Wisp Mother. Another book on the Ethereum Wars. Those things seem to be popping up everywhere. Okay. Well, now that I've already read the dang book. Book. Enchanter's Primer. Cool. Sell this to the librarian at the College Winter Hold. He typically gives good prices for books. Oh. Didn't even realize I walked right through that. You know what? I think I know why they're using ice magic. They don't want the glacier to melt and collapse in on them. That would make the most sense, at least. yours has a hood. Ooh, taking it. It's kind of pointless for me to sneak considering that my magic makes noise. But that's not how smoke works. Are you guys serious? Okay, you know what? I'm getting sick of you guys. You're. Okay. Potions? Oh dear. Good job. Stop with your crap, please. Well, considering that, yes. Just, yes, I do. Take that cell. That sucks. They kind of guaranteed that nobody was making it out alive. Conjure familiar? I don't think I have that already. I do have that already, dang it. Well, I'm not going to be able to open that lock. I'll try anyway. That didn't work. Oh, I'm close, though. It's over here. Ah, not that far. Oh my god, where is it? Just gotta get that sweet spot. Yeah, forget that. Well, sell and enchant and whatever. Just take all that stuff. That's all really good stuff. Black Soul Gem. Larina. I don't think there's any way for me to save her. I don't think there's any way for me to get up here in time to save her. They gave her a name, though, so there's bound to be some way. That's a lot of blood. Something I actually didn't know about this game is that there's actually a high-level restoration magic that can actually resurrect the dead. The only thing is it can only resurrect people who have recently died. So, say your companion dies, you can bring them back to life. But if a person is supposed to die, like Larina here, I don't think it can bring them back. And if you just find the person dead, typically they're just gone. Where am I going? Wait, this isn't the spot that I was at before. Is that any other snow? Ah, here it is. Cool. Once again, a lot of wine bottles. Wonder what they were doing. Okay. So, luckily not vampires, necromancers, because I do not want to have to jump all the way back to Whiterun just to cure myself of vampirism. That would be really annoying. I don't want to become a vampire either. That would be equally as annoying. Because I would need a black soul gem. With a black soul. With a, well, a filled black soul gem. Why is this on fire? Well, you did something wrong. Can I see what... necklace. It's just her necklace. Yzra's necklace. His or hers. I can't really tell. It's a burnt corpse. Well, that actually just goes to show what, what the guy who teaches you magic, ow, was saying. Magic can be dangerous if you don't know how to control it. God. This goes to show you how dangerous it can be. Try to use a flame cloak, end up burning yourself in a small area along with you. That's actually a neat little thing they added into that. I'm actually surprised. Because typically when you look at magic, it doesn't harm the user. They couldn't control it, and so it didn't just do a mild bit of burn. It didn't just... what the heck? I don't know why that happened. It didn't just burn them, but straight up burn them to a crisp. It killed them. Jeez. Well, now I got flame cloak. That'll be useful. Okay. Wait, is this piece of the gaulder fragment in Dawnstar? I don't remember a piece being in Dawnstar, but could be wrong. It's been a while since I actually did this mission. This quest, I guess. I'll be over there shortly. I know I get distracted really easily, but it's a lot of cool stuff to look at. What is this thing? Looks like an old watchtower or something. It's an old lighthouse. That's cool. Looks like oh, I know exactly where I'm headed to. The Dark Brotherhood Sanctuary over here in Dawnstar. Yeah. And once more, a little bit of blood outside and some nightshade. Lovely. I'm not even going to bother talking to that door because that door is creepy. And I don't like it. Alright. Didn't think it was in Dawnstar. How far am I going? I could literally just teleport over here. Sorry, I guess I was wasting everybody's time. I don't want to be in the city. I want to be right outside the city. Become friends with someone, they may allow you to take certain items from their home. They typically do, and it's typically quite a bit, depending on how friendly you get with them. I'm not talking like marry the person or whatever, but just do a favor for a do a few favors for a person, and they tend to like you a whole lot. Like, to an impressive degree, they will let you take every last coin they have and just about all of the expensive materials as well. It's weird, though. Most of the time, things that I've noticed is they will not let you take some cheap equipment. Well, some of the time. They won't let you take some of the cheap equipment that costs very little. But when it comes to... Ooh, bucket of fish. But when it comes to the expensive stuff, I don't really mind that much. It's kind of weird. Some of them are like that. Some of them are the exact opposite, where they'll be really cheap and be like, yeah, you can take this. I guess it all just depends on how much they like you. You talk to them, they like what you have to say, they'll let you take a few small things from their house. Then if you actually do a quest and help them out in that way, they let you take quite a bit of stuff from their house. Alright. Death bell. Okay. Finally, Folgenthur, we're at the crypt that contains the second piece of the Gaulder amulet. And I'm going to have to leave this episode here. So thank you everybody so much for watching. Sorry to leave it on such a cliffhanger like that, but I will hope to see you in the next episode. Bye guys!